got another one. It's her. Who that? Big baby slide through in that drop top. Something by Benz looking cute. That's honest. Her and her friends. Big blinks and snatch waist. Yeah, she brought the. Ain't no way somebody daddy ain't gonna give her the spins with her ends. Cause yeah, she did it. She did it again. A few more tracks and this time she bought friends. Big baby on her way up and showed the stats to a man's. Now salute the general. TGLX got plans. Yeah. Damn, it's the intro? Yes, it's the intro. Damn, this is the intro? Yes, yes, it's the intro.
They don't know what the info. It be coming like this on the intro. What they here for? If they want the heat, you know who to send for your info. Buy my money like Venmo. This music don't work out. I know how to get it from my ends low. How you feel, though? Cause, hey, they can't rock with us. Galaxy ain't no stopping us. They ain't trying to steal my style. I'm feeling like I just shopping. Can't trust him cause he numb. Cause we worry about getting figures. I'm a ain't father figures. Just know my quick to pop it.
Damn, it's the intro? Yes, it's the intro. Damn, this is the intro? Yes, it's the intro. Damn, it's the intro? Yes, it's the intro. Damn, this is the intro? Yes, it's the intro.
God, oh God, this is on a God level. The sun, the sky, you can see the vibe. We ride the high, always on a high level. So open up your eyes better. Why these tell me? You can join the journey, you is worthy. Just allow me, no. Kicking down your door. Bloodsuckers, I see this industry is filled with sheep. People that pretend to be something that they would never be. Oh my, I just need some little old peace of mind.
The sons of kings, the ghouls of gods. The moon, the light, the fools, the fags.
My God, oh God, this is on a God level. The sun, the sky, you can see the vibe. We ride the high, always on a high level. So open up your eyes, baby.
I can never be controlled. Let them know. 500 helicopters driving me guns so. But they watch you just to envy. Let them see it. I'm the first to say it. Now it's time you just believe it. I got too many fakes, made lots of foes. These people cold. Talk down your dreams because they know they can't come close. Don't shake no hands, they'll steal your friends. I walk alone. I see false idols. All the titles you need to grow.
I've been watching mine, but I ain't like the others no more. God, I'm learning lessons as I go. You're only wasting time. Tell the devil there's a door. Praying God is only trying to test me for the
throne.
This is on a God level. The sun, the sky, you can see the vibe. We ride the high, always on a high level. So open up your eyes, baby.
Put me in the game. Yeah. Put me in the game. Part of that
talking just sound like a show. I'm just letting you know that I'm not in the tank. Hey, coach. Put me in the game. They put me in, so I'm going in. You play for fun, I'm playing to win. Back on the wall, I'm ready for war. If I beat them before, I could beat them again. They thought I was done, I went on the run and beat all the odds and got even again. Watch what you say, I'm not one of them. When I jump in my bag, I could jump out the gym. Take a look at my legacy, I gotta let them see I'm out here winning, cause I'm on a mission. Put me in the game, cause the way I'm feeling, I honestly do not see no competition. I gotta get it, so it ain't no quitting. We jumped off the benches and jumped in the trenches. No one is better than all of us, and that's why all of us been winning from the beginning. It's more than a game. Don't play with my name. You come with your goals, I'm bringing my game. All of that talking just sound like a show. I'm just letting you know that I'm not entertained. You hear the crowd, they screaming my name. I got the stadium going insane. Done with the talking, it ain't no discussion. You started, I finished. Put me in the game. Put me in the game. Yeah. Put me in the game. All of that talking just sound like a show. I'm just letting you know that I'm not entertained. Hey, coach. Put me in the game.
Candlestick Point as we welcome you inside Levi's Stadium in Santa Clara. Today we've got a good NFC matchup on tap
between the Washington Commanders
and the San Francisco 49ers. We've got the gift of the NFL as we're underway here in Week 16.
And here comes a return from just beyond the goal line.
And no chance to get away as they'll get him down at about the 17-yard line.
Start on the ground with Gibson.
And this will leave him a yard short. Nice pickup of 9 yards on first down.
This defense for the Niners, they were terrific a week ago in the win over Seattle.
I have to admit, I was extremely impressed by what I saw on tape because they stayed in the face of the quarterback the entire game, ended up getting 4 sacks total, and made it difficult for him to step up and find receivers downfield. Also made it hard for him to escape the pocket and run.
The last run got 9. That leaves him with 2nd and 1 yard. First carry of the game for Brian Robinson. 9 yards to pick up there, and it's a first down.
Usually we see runs like this as the defense breaks down later in the game, but this guy set the tone early, running through all types of tackles and put the defense back on its heels.
Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down.
Straight ahead, Gibson.
And he's across the 40, 3 extra yards to the 43.
This time they'll throw it with Howell.
Open man is Samuel, complete.
And they'll get this down to around the 47-yard line.
So from inside Niner territory now, this is 1st and 10 at the 47.
First down, Howell to throw.
This is caught by his tight end, Logan Thomas. And he'll be brought down inside the 40-yard line. That's a staple of this offense, drag route to the tight end.
Yeah, he's unable to use his size to break off much more yardage after the catch, but still an effective gain nonetheless.
From the 39, Powell. A quick throw there, going to be batted away and incomplete. Christmas Eve here in 2022. A big slate today of Saturday games. But we will have, ready for this, a triple header of action on Christmas Day tomorrow. I think it's pretty safe to say we won't have a white Christmas in any of these places, however. We start with the Packers and Dolphins in Miami at 1 Eastern. Then you got the Broncos and Rams from Los Angeles. And then finally, the Bucks and Cardinals at 8:20 Eastern in the desert. Plus one more for good measure on Monday. Once the family's all gone back home and Grandma's punted out of the house, grab the leftovers and sit back and watch the Chargers and the Colts from Indianapolis. He's got the hookup downfield to Samuel. And he's going to be taken down right at the 10-yard line. Well, this is what you want to see from your rookie quarterback on an opening drive, Charles. He looks cool. He looks calm. He looks collected in marching them down the field.
And, Brandon, I just think the game continues to change and evolve because we're calling these guys rookies. But, you know, they've thrown the football so much.
But I think the ball's out. And that was a scooped up by the 49ers. And a very good return as he'll take it all the way up to the 40-yard line.
Let's face it, everybody at the start of a game has a mental image of how they expect it to go, and I think that was going exactly as they scripted it offensively, moving the ball well, seemingly in control, and that fumble, that's got to be a little bit deflating, don't you think?
Yep, foiled the whole plan there, turned the ball over. The drive begins with a run by McCaffrey. He was solid last week, over 100 yards in their victory on the ground. They want to get that going again.
Absolutely. What they also understand is that from week to week, it's not necessarily the same, but they want it to be, right? What they saw last week on the ground, they want to see in this game as well.
They'll send a receiver in motion to the right. Another run with McCaffrey on second down. And he'll get it down to the 47 here. 4 yards the pickup, first down. The Niners at 9-5 now on the year. And they come in feeling pretty good after back-to-back victories, CD.
And I thought that they played pretty well last week. Their execution, their discipline, their resilience, all on display in that victory.
Now to throw off the play action. Out to his left. Gets this one to Juszczyk. And they're going to get this to about the 44-yard line. He was out there waving his arms. And when you got a quarterback out of the pocket looking for any help, I guess waving the arms is helpful.
It certainly is, because you got to get his attention, because now you're in scramble drill. So everyone's adjusting their routes, finding open space, and he found the right spot for the completion.
Let's go.
From the 44, Purdy. Man open, that's Deebo Samuel. And he takes this just a few yards shy of the red zone before going out. That good for 21 yards on the catch and run. Really been an ideal start for them. They get the turnover on the opening possession. Now here they are moving the ball straight down the field on their first drive.
And that feels good, but you know on their side of the field, all they're thinking is, finish this drive off, because they took it away, right? So now you've got them back on their heels a little bit. Now go down, put a touchdown on them. Look out. You've won the mental battle early in the game, and that may carry over for you.
No score after one on EA Sports. On first down, it's Purdy. This one caught by Kittle. And he's out of bounds. Almost gets to the 10. 11 more on that one and another first down.
A lot of tight ends just use their size and their strength, try to occupy some space and kind of body people away and catch the football. But not this guy. He's a refined route runner. Makes me wonder if he took some dance classes in his background with his footwork.
Purdy off the play fake. And he's got it. Touchdown 49ers. Brandon Ayuk, his fifth touchdown now on the year. And the Niners post the first points of the ball game as they take the lead here in this second quarter. Charles, every time that he makes one of these plays, I think the front office, they get a bigger and bigger collective smile because they feel more confident that they have found their guy, their future at quarterback.
And they should feel that way. It's obvious he's a big part of why they have such a good record this season. You're right about the bright future as well, and by association, a bright future for the franchise too.
Here is Wisnowski to boot it away following the touchdown. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. Out there, set and ready for this next drive, the Washington offense. They had the fumble on the last drive, wound up leading to the opening touchdown. Now they'll try again here, first and 10. Yeah, this will be a gain of 5 as he gets it to the 30.
Brandon, 5 yards on that run. Let's get back to the huddle and make sure you're back. You spend time with your offensive line and give them credit. Hard to move those 300-plus pounders at the line of scrimmage, and they did for a significant chunk of yardage.
From the 30 on second down, Powell. And he can't get rid of it. He's taken down. Melvin Ingram able to record his 5th sack of the season.
Well, you just knew that these rushers were eager to do that today. Put him on the ground. Their plan? Introduce themselves individually to this rookie quarterback. They said hello in a big way there with a loss of double-digit yards on that sack.
Now on 3rd and long, they'll look to throw. And pressure coming, and they got him once again. Nick Bosa providing a little deja vu, back-to-back sacks, and now they're staring at a 4th and long. Tress Way on 4th down is sent out to punt. Only 2 punts for him last week in the loss as he gets this one away. Taken from just outside the 30. That's going to go in the books as a 55-yard punt. Well done. And the Niners will go on offense, 1st and 10. The 49er offense set to get this drive underway. They've got the 7-0 lead. Now they've got the football back after their defense got the stop, CD. And you get the feeling if they could score here, they'd really have all the momentum on their side.
And you just wonder right now, is the quarterback and the play caller totally in sync? Are they of one mind that, hey, what worked last time? Let's keep doing it until they stop us. Or do they go to a different section in the playbook, show them something different? Either way, they want a repeat of their first drive.
So after the incompletion on first, now 2nd and 10. They go play action here. Purdy forced out to his left. And seeing nowhere to throw, he chucks this one away from harm. Incomplete. Now it's 3rd down.
Well, they approach this drive with a lot of confidence after their last one ended up as a touchdown. But incompletions on their first 2 throws has them huddling up and trying to figure out a big play here on 3rd down to get their momentum going again.
Yeah.
Now they face a third and 10 after back-to-back incompletions. They just do get the playoff as he'll look to throw. And they're able to work this across midfield to the 48.
I don't care how many times we say it, I still get a kick out of watching quarterbacks and receivers do the pass trick in pregame warm-up. But I always remember that when we go to practices, we see that after practices as well. They really tune it up, don't they?
They tune it up. They know why they do it for these situations. First down.
And they build that trust, and that's why they're able to find him in this type of a situation.
Purdy looking to throw on first down here. And trying to get it to Samuel, but it's intercepted. Picked off by Benjamin St. Juice. And he will bring this one back. An interception return for a Commanders touchdown. Well, it turns out it's not their offense who gets him on the board first, CD. It's the defense coming through right there with a pick six.
And I know from experience throughout the week when you go against the offense, you're challenging them all the time. You're letting them know, hey, don't worry about scoring this week. We'll take care of it. We'll get a few pick sixes and score ourselves. You're just kidding? But how about what he just did right there? Laid it out for the rest of the game. We scored. Hey, offense, can you keep up with us?
So all even at seven now as they kick it away. Taken at the goal line. And he'll be out of bounds across the 25. San Francisco offense ready to start their next drive. Now remember, they were just out here a moment ago through the pick six, so we'll see if they can take better care of the football this go around. And trying to get it to Samuel, but it's intercepted. Picked off by Cameron Curl, and he will bring this one back. It is a pick six for a Washington touchdown. But Charles, you can just see the frustration on the sideline. Safe to say that's not how they expected this series to go. The ball only went one way, and it was backward into their own end zone, courtesy of the pick six.
And Brandon, how often do we hear offenses tell us before a game they want to end every series with a kick, right? A punt, a PAT, or a field goal? In case of a defense, they want it to end with a punt or a takeaway. And we saw the takeaway right there, and it turned out to be a takeaway that turned into 6 points.
From a couple yards deep, he'll bring it out of the end zone. The lane opens here. He's past the 30. And they are not going to catch him. He's in. Touchdown, 49ers.
That was a special return, and it happened because he's a special returner. He has to have that approval from his special teams coach's head coach to bring it out of the end zone.
But let's be honest, a lot of times when they bring it out of the end zone like he did there, they don't have approval. I mean, I think a lot of times they do, but correct me if I'm wrong. Sometimes it's just a guy getting a feel, right?
Yeah, exactly right. What's the old adage? Sometimes you just have to know when to break the rules. And if you do, you're taking on some responsibility. But he was happy to do so there.
This one tied at 14 now as he sends this one away. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. Let's go. Out there, set and ready for this next drive, the Washington offense. We have seen a lot of points here in this quarter. For us up here in the booth, it's been fun to watch. The defensive coordinators probably scratching their heads.
Yeah, they're going a little bit crazy right now. But let's face it, all of our friends who play fantasy, they're enjoying the heck out of this show because most of them are creating and getting a bunch of points.
Yeah, points certainly not at a premium here.
Now a throw here to his running back. This will be stopped about 2 yards shy of the marker. 8 yard gain, second and two. Second down, Hal back to pass. That's complete. Terry McLaurin with it. And this will move the chains again as the tackle's going to be made at the 49ers 43. They'll throw on first down. Here's Hal. And that one drops down, incomplete. Good coverage there, forced the ball free, and it's second down.
Well, the incompletion, yes, but maybe here not the worst thing in the world?
No, not on first and 10. Actually gives them a chance to regroup, relax just a little bit. They huddle up, talk it over, then they get a chance to continue their drive.
The 49ers now going to use the first of their timeouts as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play. Making the handoff, Howell. Toward the sideline, and look at that catch. Dragging the toes, and that's going to be a first down. Well done. He got 29 yards that time.
Let's make this one simple. What a catch, especially the finishing part of getting his feet in bounds, toe tapping, and, of course, foot dragging.
A little tapestry, if you will.
Oh, I like it.
Inside the red zone here. They'll look to throw. And a big loss here as he's taken down. Dre Greenlaw getting home on that one.
He saw the pressure and he got out, but he never got upfield. And the defense, they took full advantage of a rookie mistake there. They were able to add a big loss on the sack.
Sacks a growing theme in this first half. This is second and long. Another try after the first down sack. Powell. And he will find his man, Samuel. And he is out of bounds, but first he gets it inside the 10 to the 7. A big gain there after going backwards, and that'll lead to a third down.
And that was yardage that they needed there after the sack on first down. They didn't get all of it back, but now they look at third down as a manageable situation, one that they have a much better chance of picking up.
Robinson will try to pick it up. And he takes it in. Touchdown, Commanders. Brian Robinson Jr. with his 9th rushing touchdown on the year. And the Commanders will take the lead here in the final minute of the first half. The extra point by Sly is up and good. And the lead is now 21-14. Kick team out there for the Commanders as they send this one away. From a yard or two deep, here comes a return. And in hindsight, probably should have taken a knee as he only gets this out to the 16-yard line. The 49er offense set to get this drive underway. And the ball backed way up. So thinking with this amount of time on the clock, probably just sit on it, and we'll see these two teams go to the lockers.
Yeah, I don't think you want to overthink it in this situation. Either side of the ball. Just go ahead and finish up the half and get on out and talk about it.
But I guess that answers the question whether or not they want him throwing it again right away after throwing the pick six on the previous drive.
Yeah, not something conservative or underneath. Pretty big shot right there.
Get him right back in the saddle and say, go ahead and sling it, big guy.
Throwing again on second and 10. Purdy. That's to the right side, complete to Kittle. Now San Francisco going to call their second timeout as they stop it with 16 seconds to go in half number one.
That was good protection there. No, that was great protection there because it allowed him to lock in on his receiver, although I think he was looking for his tight end on the corner route all the way. Nice connection there for a really nice gain.
From the 34 now, here's first and 10. Purdy to throw it on first down. He's going to launch this thing way downfield. And this is caught inside the five. Touchdown. Danny Gray in the final seconds of the first half. And the 49ers have a chance to tie the game here in the final seconds of the half. Extra point right down the middle. And that is going to tie our game as we approach halftime. A couple of teams locked into a good one here. 21 all the score as the kick's away. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. They're set and ready for this next drive, the Washington offense. And with only 9 seconds remaining, well, not much time, we'll see how they play this. And defensively, they're just looking to keep him contained as they're able to get him down. And with just 4 seconds left in this first half, a timeout call. Here's a second and two now from the 33. They'll keep it on the ground again here. And they're going to be waiting for him as they get him behind the line. So we are at halftime here on Christmas Eve. As we'll send you back over to Orlando with our EA Sports Halftime Report, here's Jonathan Coachman. And we welcome you back live now inside the booth alongside Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gordon, set and ready to rock for the third quarter. And ready to get the party started for the second half. It was an even first half, all tied on the scoreboard. And this is going to be returned from the middle of the end zone. And he's going to be brought down inside the five at the three.
Well, not exactly a banner return, so he doesn't give his offense a whole lot of room to work with. They've got to go a long way now to try and score some points. I do know this from experience. There will be a few comments muttered his way by the offense as they head out on the field.
The San Francisco offense ready to start their next drive. This offense ready for the first drive of the third quarter. Well, quarters number one and two entertaining. We saw some good offense points put up, Charles, and all tied on the scoreboard.
And it sets us up for what could be a really fun second half because we've seen both sides score almost at will here in the first half. And now here in the second half, getting the ball first, you've got to think, hey, we can go out and really run our offense the way we did in the first half. But if I'm a defensive player, all I'm thinking is, can I make a play to really help out my team and break this streak of offense?
Now they have a little more space to maneuver from the 15, first and 10. Now a draw play to McCaffrey. And he's going to lose yardage here back to the 14-yard line. Jamin Davis, the one to get up from his linebacker spot and make that play.
I think it's pretty evident we can say what a difference a week makes. Last week, he ran pretty much wild, didn't he? Did pretty much what he wanted to do. But this one, they've stopped him cold. That, to me, that's good scouting and even better execution.
Yeah, and they stopped him behind the line right there. They obviously watched the tape a few times and made some adjustments. So the first down run lost a couple. Now they come up second and 12. Play action, now Purdy. Winds up and lets it go for Samuel. And he's gonna be intercepted for the third time thus far. And the Commanders are gonna take possession of the football.
Well, it's not the first time we've seen him give one up here during his rookie season. And in this case, zone coverage forced the mistake. He's made some strides week to week in how he's handling the different type of coverages that he's seeing. But clearly, there's some growing still to do.
On first and 10, it's Gibson. And the result here, a pickup of 8. Leaves him with 2 to go on second down.
First play of the drive, let's give credit all around. Excellent blocking, but the guy carrying the ball, he was the finisher. A really nice run.
8 yards the tally on that first down run. Here's second and 2. Out of the gun, it's Howell. And it's intercepted at the goal line. Isaiah Oliver with the INT. And now off to the races, down the right side. 20. And into the end zone, a pick six for the 49D as they score the touchdown.
Well, this secondary just continues to be a force. Multiple interceptions in this game, and now the pick six.
And the thing about it is once you get an interception as a unit, you think to yourself, okay, we got that. How do we increase it the next time? Get the interception, do a little more damage, and there's your outcome right there. Take it to the house and break down what they're trying to do offensively.
So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six, and now the kick is away. This taken in at the goal line. And he'll be tackled just shy of the 25. Out there set and ready for this next drive, the Washington offense. Powell throwing again after the pick six. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete.
Partner, what we're seeing so far is the defense is certainly coordinated. Both levels doing their jobs in tandem. The back helping the front helping the back. The pressure got home on that last play and forced him to try and throw through contact and short of the sticks.
To throw again on second down, Powell. Throw right side, taken in by Gibson. That helps the completion percentage, but not much else. And now it's 3rd and 10.
As a defense, you're more balanced when you're in zone coverage because you're able to keep your eyes on the quarterback and see the play develop in front of you. They're able to keep the quick pass in front of them and stop it right at the line of scrimmage.
Right where this set of downs started, they need a full 10 here to pick up the first down and move the chains. Howell throwing on 3rd down here. Slings this deep from McLaurin. And he fires one that's intercepted. Picked up by Diamador Lenoir. Dances by him. And the Niners are going to take possession here at their own 33.
I think he thought he had his first read open on that one, but they were obviously ready for that throw. And that's just a lack of experience showing. Young quarterback stared his man down the whole way, and they were more than happy to sit on that route and bring home the INT.
The 49er offense set to get this drive underway. So now, Charles, this drive, maybe a touch more important, trying to erase the memory of that interception they had the last time out.
Yeah, and everyone goes through this because even the best in the game, you're going to have games where it just doesn't go right for you and interceptions result. So, frankly, to me, it's all about how you respond, not just the types of plays that you call,
but how you carry yourself, how you show your team that you're still with it, and how you continue to lead.
Third quarter action, and we appreciate you spending your Christmas Eve right here with us. Second and 10. Up the gut, McCaffrey. And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. 15 for the Niners there on first down.
Sometimes it's hard to believe, but there are times this game is about patience, isn't it? Has had the game he expected, but that run there, that may get him going.
I was just going to say, maybe that gives him a little juice, because you're right, he struggled, especially in that first half.
Yeah, and I know the great ones always think to themselves, just hang in there. I'm just one big carry away from busting this open. That's a good start for him.
Room here to run. And great blocking downfield as he's got this almost to the 35-yard line. 55 rushing yards rushing for him so far in this one as he nears 1,400 for the year. From Commanders territory now, it's first and 10 at the 36. And he'll toss this one incomplete. Seeing no options, he throws it away.
Well, they've been back on their heels a little bit here in this drive, but a chance to exhale just a little bit there with incompletion on first down. Now they have to gear up, try and get two more stops and escape this drive.
You can do better.
Third quarter of a tight football game as we come up on a second and 10. They'll bring a receiver in motion left. Second down, here's Purdy to throw. And this one almost intercepted. Far too loose with the football, nearly a fourth pick of the ball game.
Trying to decipher what's going on out there, because I don't know if he's just getting bad reads. I don't know if the defense is confusing him. I don't know if he just has, you know, bad info and intel before he snaps the ball. But he's made some pretty bad decisions with the football lately.
Yeah, several bad decisions on the interceptions he's thrown. And frankly, that should have been another pick right there. So back-to-back incompletions, and that has him staring at a third and 10.
From the gun. That's going to be caught along the sideline, and what a job of keeping his feet in bounds. They say that's a catch. That's a third down conversion to 24 yards there. Nice play. A bit of a catch for him to remember. That's number 400 for his NFL career. Not a bad number at all. From down at the 12, it's first and 10. McCaffrey running up the middle. And he's going to battle his way down right around the 2-yard line. 9 yards is the pickup there, and they'll have a second and one.
Looks to me like maybe there's a little attrition setting in with this drive, because when you see that type of a run, I get the feeling the defense gets a little bit tired.
And that's the last thing they need, especially when they look up at the scoreboard. Now they bring a receiver in motion right.
Second down and right back to McCaffrey. And he's going to take it in. Touchdown, San Francisco. Christian McCaffrey taking it in from 2 yards out. And the Niners will add on to their lead here in the final minute of the third.
Point after here coming up. Now he's been a busy man, 5 for 5 now, as he knocks another one through to extend the lead.
Here is Wisnowski to boot it away following the touchdown. And here comes a return from just beyond the goal line. And they'll get him down right around the 25, actually the 26 officially, so a net gain of 1 there.
Oh,
out there setting ready for this next drive, the Washington offense.
They're sort of seeing themselves spiral out of control. Let's see if they can get things back on track.
And this is where the coach is walking that line of being calm and really being firm with his team. Had one tell me once, you know, when we were having a tough patch, this too shall pass, and it finally kept having a rough patch. He said, but you've got to do something to make it pass. And that's what they have to do. They've got to get some control back, get themselves reasserted, and calm things down.
See if they can get calm and reassert themselves here.
One quarter remains here in week 16. This is the National Football League on EA Sports. So signs of life in what's been a dormant offense in this second half. Here's first and 10. Off play action. It's Howell. There goes a deep ball. End zone. And that is caught. Touchdown, Washington. Terry McLaurin, 57 yard. Slide for the PAT. And that'll cut the lead down now to a touchdown. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. From a couple yards deep, he'll bring it out of the end zone. And he will be brought down here inside the 20. Good coverage as he's dropped at the 17. San Francisco offense ready to start their next drive. Their lead back down to one score after the touchdown a moment ago. First down's a must on this drive as they start out here first and 10. Play action, and now here's Purdy to throw it. This will be caught. It's Samuel. And he'll be corralled well upfield right around the 40-yard line. Executed 22-yard gain. Tell you what, he's been able to put the ball in some tight spots all game long. That throw, no different.
Yeah, a lot of people would call it a gutsy type of a throw. I think he looks at it as, I can do it, so it's not that big of a deal to me, and I'm going to keep firing.
In motion goes the tight end.
On first down, this is McCaffrey. Nowhere to go that time. He maybe got a yard up to the 40. This defense starting to buckle down when they need to, and right now they're winning this fourth quarter, losing the game, but they're winning in the fourth quarter.
And what a fine line it is about what they're trying to get done, because they're down, so they obviously need the football, need a score, but they can't be so aggressive as to give up their edge, their gaps, and have the offense hit them with a big play.
The run only got a yard. Here's second and 9. Again, they run. Again, it's McCaffrey. And some space here. And a solid run here as he'll pick his way down the 42-yard line. 85 yards rushing now for the NFL leader coming into this ballgame.
Well, that's a carry they have to be satisfied with. And throughout this game, they've been satisfied with what he's given them. Whenever they've needed a big run, a first down, he's the guy they've turned to. And it doesn't matter what the defense thinks. They feel like they've got the confidence to keep handing it to him and keep picking up good yardage.
In motion, the tight end. They'll give it up to McCaffrey. And he fights forward for a modest 2-yard gain, second down.
Well, any lane that might have been open there was closed pretty quickly, and that was because the defensive front, they won that battle at the point of attack at the line of scrimmage. They used great leverage, held their spot, and stacked him up.
The last run good for two. Here's second and eight. This is McCaffrey on the give. And this winds up a pickup of two, maybe two and a half, to about the 39. Now the objective there, I mean, yes, the positive gain, that's nice, but work some clock.
Yeah, you're exactly right. But the problem for them is still within a possession. So they can't just sit on it running the ball. They'll have to find a way to throw it effectively as well.
If they want a first, they need to get the football to the 32 here on third down. Throwing here, Purdy. He'll get this underneath to McCaffrey. And he's going to be taken down at the 28-yard line.
And this has been a nice answer to the touchdown drive against them a few minutes ago because they've come out and reestablished the tempo. A nice throw there. And they're putting together a very strong drive as a response.
Now whistles here. And I think one of the big boys for the 49ers might have jumped. Full start, backs him up five, first and 15. McCaffrey following the penalty. And he is going to be stopped up at the line of scrimmage. And we'll have a stoppage as well as we have reached the two-minute warning. Tackle made by Chase Young. Second and long, but you got to figure this almost certainly another run. The 49ers now going to use the first of their timeouts. That'll leave them with two remaining. We'll be back after this. Second and 15. Stay on the ground, McCaffrey again. And he'll get it down inside the 30 to the 29-yard line. And now right out of the two-minute break, we'll get a timeout used defensively with a minute 56 to go. And now the question everyone's wondering, look at the clock, late fourth quarter, do they put the ball in the air here on third?
I don't. I run the football, and I tell my offensive line, no leakage up front. I don't want my running back hit as I hand the ball off to him. I don't want any type of an issue. But if I am going to throw it, quick throw, out to the perimeter, maybe one of my best receivers running a quick slant or something like that.
Third down, here's McCaffrey. And he'll get this to the 23, but that'll be well short of what he needed. The Commander's going to use the second of their timeouts. That'll be their second, so one more chance to stop the clock here, and we'll be back. And his kick is indeed good, and that will extend their lead even further. So that one, CD, going to make the road back a lot more difficult.
Oh, there's no doubt about that. You know they were praying on the other sideline for a miss because now, as you pointed out, a very difficult road. Down two scores. You don't just need a touchdown. You need a chain of events to go your way. You've got to score, somehow get the ball back, and score again. The odds of that happening, not great in your favor.
A good starting spot for Washington as they come up first and 10 at the 40. Here's Howell. Got this complete to Jahan Dotson. And he'll be brought down on the other side of midfield at the 43. Howell to throw. And he is out of bounds. runs, but not before he's inside the 30. Opted to run for it. The decision a good one. Picking up the first, getting 14 yards on the scramble. Whether it's a touchdown or a field goal, whatever it is, they need to score quickly here on first down. First down, Howell to throw. Looking for Dotson, and he's got him. And they'll get this down to the 10. Howell throwing on first down here. And he takes this down to about the 2 before going out of bounds. He'll get 8 on the scramble there. It'll be second and a couple. Now a timeout called for by the defense. That'll leave him with just one remaining in this fourth quarter of play. Second and goal, Howell. And he's just going to throw this one out of bounds here. Nowhere to go with it, incomplete.
We've seen this quite a few times in this game. Offensive line unable to keep leverage, unable to keep people away, facing a lot of pressure. Fortunate just to get rid of it.
One of the reasons they're down is that inability, though, to stop the pressure. We saw another example of it there. Howell, third and goal. Flushed out right. And that is incomplete.
Let's face it, this defense has had its share of struggles all game long, and they know that they can put it all behind them if they defend well here in the 2-minute drill. Excellent coverage right there to force the incompletion.
Down, Howell, desperation time. A hit as he throws, and this is going to be incomplete. They try to throw on fourth and goal from the 2, and that'll be just about all she wrote for this one. So with that, we can just about close the book on this one, Charles.
Yeah, what's the old expression about slim and none? Well, Slim just left town on that
They're down to none?
Yes, exactly right.
The 49er offense set to get this drive underway. And this one all over but the shouting, you might say. Now, there's one timeout remaining defensively, but probably no real need to use it here.
Yeah, the only time they would use it, strictly for pride.
Credited with a 1-yard gain there to make it 2nd and 9. Down to a knee for the 49ers. This one about to be on ice. So the victory here from San Francisco, and they were really helped by their defense, forcing 3 turnovers.
I think what we saw in this one, today's defense. And what I mean by that is in the old days, pitching shutouts was big time. That was paramount. But the big thing was holding people down, holding down their yardage, right? Don't let them throw the ball through the air and gain a lot. But now, it's about taking the ball away, taking away possessions, getting the ball back for their offense. They had 3 takeaways in this one, and it led them to victory.
So for the 49ers, it's an important win for their playoff hopes as they hit the 10-win mark now at 10-5. And they will hit the road next week. Meanwhile, for Washington, their playoff hopes take a big hit as they fall to 8-7. And they'll try to make amends next week as they host the Cleveland Browns.